This week on Wheel of Science, we're talking asteroids.
Right, Neil? We ain't talking about my asteroid, for sure. This is Wheel of Science.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to Wheel of Science, the interactive show where we answer your questions about the universe. And by we, I certainly don't mean me. We have with us the one, the only, your own personal astrophysicist, Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson! What's up, Neil?
Chuck, how you doing?
Thanks for asking, man. I'm great. Where are you beaming in from?
From Vancouver, British Columbia. And for geographically challenged Americans, that's Canada, filming the last few days of Cosmos.
God, you are all over the place, man. Would love to be you right now.
Let's not get into your fantasies.
Okay. All right. It's time to talk asteroids. Are you ready, Neil?
I'm ready, Chuck. Spin that wheel.
Daniel Tickner wants to know, what is the easiest way to defend the Earth from asteroids? I didn't even know they were trying to attack us.
What you want to do is first find out that it's headed our way. Then, as early as you possibly can, slowly deflect it out of harm's way. Because if the earlier you get it, you don't have to deflect it by very much, and that angle accumulates and gets wider and wider and wider so that it completely misses Earth. The later you do this, the more significant you have to deflect it so that it does not hit Earth. And if it's headed right at us, you have to deflect it the entire diameter of the Earth just to avoid collision. So the earlier the better in all cases. So how would you do that? Well, one way is you can like paint one side of the asteroid jet black, and that'll absorb more sunlight than the other side. And when that happens, it radiates at a different rate from one side to the other. And that difference in radiation rates has a pressure that pushes it into a new orbit. But there's still issues of how much spray paint do you need for this? Or what would you actually take out there to accomplish this? And these asteroids are large. The ones we're worried about are miles across, okay? And if you're European, kilometers across. But that's a lot of spray paint. So, is another way to do it? Yes. You can send a spaceship out there and have it, a space probe, and park it near the asteroid. So here's the asteroid and here's the space probe. Just park it there. Now what's going to happen is their gravity is going to want to attract them to one another. But you don't let that happen. You fire little retro rockets. So that pulls the spaceship a little farther away, and then the asteroid falls towards it. And it's very steady. But it is, in effect, a gravitational tractor beam. It's like a gravitational tether. And that way you can measure how effective it is and how long you should do it. And so that's clearly the best way to protect Earth from asteroids.
So blowing it up Armageddon style, that's not a good choice?
No. In America especially, we're really good at blowing stuff up, but we're not as good at knowing where the pieces will land. So you don't know what effect exploding it will have after you've blown it up.
So what you're saying, Neil, is Bruce Willis is a fraud.
No. The way I put it is, if we are going to blow it up, for whatever reason, I'd send Bruce Willis.
All right, Neil, it's time for another question. Are you ready?
Spin the wheel.
Matthew Vincent Liberto wants to know this. When considering the asteroid belt, where did all the asteroids come from? I'm genuinely curious. Also, if there were an asteroid headed towards Earth, how would it be made known to the public? Okay, Neil, so where'd the asteroids come from?
Well, first let me say where they are. Most of them are between the orbit of Mars and Jupiter. Hundreds of thousands of them. And they're craggy chunks of rock left over from the formation of the solar system. And we think many of them tried to become planets, like planetesimals. And the solar system back then was basically a shooting gallery. And as they're trying to become planets, they get broken up into bits and pieces. So they're really the vagabonds of the solar system.
So what you're saying is it's space garbage, like Pluto.
Chuck, don't get me started.
Okay, I'm joking. Okay, how about the second half of Matt's question? How are we going to know that we're all going to die?
Well, all the movies always show governments detecting the asteroid with some special telescopes and then keeping it a secret. Excuse me, you cannot keep the sky a secret. It is above all our heads, and there are countless thousands of amateur astronomers with backyard telescopes that look into the universe and find these things. And so you realize that most comets, up until recently, most comets were found by amateur astronomers. And asteroids, too. So now we have specialized telescopes, but they're controlled by us, not by the government. So, yeah, if we find one, you're going to know the next day, because that stuff will go public. And then everybody will find out at the same time, very likely via the internet. And it is no secret anybody can keep.
Sorry, Neil, I don't believe you. I got a feeling they're not telling anybody anything, and then they're going to take that information and escape on their own. Or maybe that's just what I would do. I'm an awful person. Which makes me wonder, if we were going to get hit by an asteroid, would you want to know? Vote in the poll on the screen right now and see what everybody else thinks. Hey, man, thanks for being here. As always, it's my pleasure. Until next time, this is Chuck Nice for Wheel of Science saying, keep that asteroid.